This video discusses how to use a C++ program to read a file that contains numeric data and determine the mean and the median of that numeric data. Let's start off with a couple definitions. The mean is commonly known as the average, so I need to count the number of data items at the same time get a total of all the data items. I'll take the total divided by the count, and that gives us the mean, or commonly known as the average. In this example, I have 8,000, 9,000, 9,000, 9,500, etc. So there's a total of 9 data items, and the total of the data items is 411,500. The mean is calculated as 411,500 divided by 9, which becomes 45,722.22. One of the nice things about computing the mean is the data values do not need to be sorted. All we have to do is add them up, come up with the total, and divide by the count. The median is a little bit different. What I need to do is to have a sorted list. So if there's 9 data items, then the 5th item is the one that's in the middle. In this case, if I have 8,000, 9,000, 9,500, etc., then the 5th item in the list is 10,000. So the median is 10,000. Working with a list that has an even number, it's a little bit more complicated to determine the median value because there isn't anything that's exactly in the center. So what I have to do is to take the 2 different values, one on each side, and come up with the average, and that becomes the median. So the median is half the values are below this value and half the values are above this value. So then, if I have 10 data items, and the 5th data item is 10,000, and the 6th data item is 11,000, I take the 10,000 plus 11,000, which becomes 21,000, divide by 2. So the median is 10,500. That means for the 10,500, half the values are below that, and half the values are above that. Again, we have to have a sorted list if I'm going to determine the median value. The mode is the number that occurs most often in the list. And my list right here, 9,000, occurs twice. For example, if there's 2 data items that occurs most often, then I have a multi-mode. I'm not going to cover how to determine the mode in this discussion. When writing the program, there are some similarities between computing the mean and the median. Let's go over the mean. I need to open the file, read each record, and as I read each record, I need to count the number of records and add a total of all those values. I can close the file and compute and display the mean. Since I have a total of all the values and a count of how many items there were, I can just take the total and divide by the count. Computing the median, there are several things that are similar. I need to open the file, read each record, and count the number of records. So this is going to be a 2-pass. The first pass, all I need to do is find out how many records are in the list. Then I can determine which one is going to be the median. I need to open the file again, skip over the records until I can get to the one that I need, and then read that record and say, ah, I found the median value. Then I can display it. Again, it's a little more complicated if I have an even number because I have to skip all the way and then read 2 values, take the average, then that becomes my median value. Let's look at the different type of data we might have in our list. So we need to know what the data looks like before we can even determine either the mean or the median. Now, if I have a file that contains only account balances, well, that's going to be pretty easy. However, I might have a file that has account number, account name, and account balance. The only one I'm really interested in is the account balance at the moment. Now, how's it organized? Well, it could be account number, account name, and account balance. Maybe the file is organized a little different to where I have account number, account balance, and account name. I need to know how the data is organized in the file before I write the program, because I have to be able to say I'm going to read each field and I have to know which order the fields are going to be. If I have account number, account name, and account balance, I can use an integer for the account number because there's no decimal places in this list. I can use the character array or string to read the account name, and then I want to use a double because the account balances have places past the decimal. I can open the file. Now in this example, I have the file on my desktop, so I can say ifstream, input file stream, infile. Infile is the name of the object that I'm going to be using to reference the file. I can open the file and create my object at the same time. Right here, I'm saying that I'm going to find that file on my desktop. So I can use my file name fully qualified, say quote, slash users, slash Dan, slash desktop, slash balances, dash one, dot text. Right there where it says Dan, that's my login name. You're going to have to put in your login name here because you're going to be working with your desktop instead of mine. Now you can put the file anywhere you want. You just have to be able to specify where the file is located. When I get ready to read a record, I can say infile greater greater account number greater greater account name greater greater account balance. And that will read one full line from the file. Here's some sample code to determine the median. It's a three-step process. Open the file, count the number of records, and close the file. I need to identify which record of the file is going to be used to determine the median. Open the disk file again. Read and ignore the records leading up to the desired records, so I'm just going to skip over those records and say, this is what I need. I need this record, or maybe I need two records and then take the average. Here is some sample code. It starts off, I have my include statements. And that stdafx.h, that's only for Microsoft Visual Studios and most versions. Here's my IO stream. That way I can use that for CN and Cout and display things on the screen. Fstream, file stream, that's so I can work with a disk file. And then CSTDLIB, so this is the C standard library. That's so I can use the exit function. I say using namespace standard, so I don't have to keep putting std in front of a whole bunch of stuff. Here are my variables. Ifstream, infile. Ifstream is the class name that's part of fstream. Ifstream is for input file stream. If I wanted to output and write to a file, I'd have to create an object using ofstream. So now throughout the program, anytime I want to work with this file, inside the program, I'm going to use the object infile. Here are some variables for each record in the file. I have an int for account number, a character array for account name, and a double for account balance. I'll use these variables each time I read a record from the file. The next time I read another record in the file, I'll reuse the variables. So, here are some more variables for determining the median. I have my record count because I need to know how many records are in the file. When I get ready to figure out the median itself, I need to know how many records to skip, so I'm setting up another variable here. I have a total. The total is a total of all the balances. Also, in this program, compute the mean and the median, so I have two separate variables for those. Let's determine the mean. When I determine the mean, one of the byproducts is I have a count of the number of records, and I can use this when I reopen the file again to determine the median. Cout, enter the name of the data file. Console in, input the name of the file. Then I'll do the open, infile.open, file name. I need to check to make sure that I was able to open the file. Maybe I couldn't find the file, so there's no point in continuing running the rest of the program if I wasn't able to open the file. If I couldn't open the file, I'll display unable to open, and I'll say what the file name was, and then I'll exit the program. If I can open the file, then I'll continue with the program. I'm going to read the first record before the while loop, and then the last thing in the while loop, I'll read the next record. So infile, greater greater account number, greater greater account name, greater greater account balance, so that's going to read one record. If the account name isn't blank, that means I had some data in that record, I'll add the account balance to the total and count the number of records. Then at the end of my while loop, I'll read the next record. Well, I have all the information I need to compute the mean. I know the total of all the balances, and I know how many records I have. So I can close the file and then use cout to display there are, I'll say how many records there are, and then the mean is the total divided by the count, and I'll display the mean. Okay, now let's determine the median. I need to figure out how many records there are before my median value, and I'll skip those records. So if the record count is odd, and I'll determine if it's odd, if I say record count mod 2, so I'm going to divide by 2 and look at the remainder. The remainder will be a 1 if it's an odd number. So then the number of records to skip is going to be record count divided by 2. If it's an even number, then I have to back up one because I'm going to need that other record. Now, I'll open up the file again, skip the leading records, make sure I can open it again, and then while the records to skip is non-zero, so if I had 5 records to skip, then I'm going to say read, 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 and when I get down to 0, hey, I'm at the spot where I can determine the median value. So all I'm going to do is decrement my records to skip. So if I had 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then read that one, I'm done. Now, you can either count up or you can count down. I could have a loop there that says count up. So if I have 5 records to skip, I can say count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as I'm reading records. Or I could do 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, and I'm done. Got the idea? You can either count up or count down. I chose to count down. For example, right here, I need to skip 5 records. Record number 6 right here is going to be my record that I need to do for my median value. Now I need to determine the median. So I'll read a record from the disk. If the count of the records is odd, all I need to do is read the record and say, oh, this is my median value. So my median is whatever the account balance is. If I have an even number of records, I need to read 2 records and determine the average. So I'll say my median is the count balance, and then I need to read another record and say add the current record to my median, add them up together and divide by 2, and then display. So far so good. Okay, if there's an even number, then I have to skip these records and then add these 2 records up together. Add these 2 values up together, divide by 2, and that's going to be my median. So half the values are below that, and half the values are above. How are you going to know if you got the right data? Well, let's compare the results using Excel. Here's an example of how to use Microsoft Excel to look at the mean and the median of the data file. First thing I'll do is open the file. I'll say File, Open. I have the file on my desktop, so I'm going to say desktop. Here's a whole bunch of folders and everything else, but my file isn't being displayed. That's because I'm only explaining Excel files. I need to say all files. Scroll down until I can find the file. In this case, I want balances-1.txt. So double-click this, and it opens up. Here is the import wizard. It is delimited, means there's some type of a separator between each field. I have a tab separator. I just happen to know that because I built the file. And say next. Here it is for column 1, column 2, column 3, etc. Finish. I'm going to make the B column a little bit wider so I can see my names. If I look at this, it says 220.5, that's really 50 cents. Here's $235, but and 0 cents. Here's $235.83. I'm going to select the entire column, say number, set for number with 2 decimal places. That just makes it look nice. scroll down to the bottom of my data. I'm going to put a comment here for mean, and the next spot, right up at the top, there's a sigma. That means here's my formulas. There's sum, average, that's the one I want. Press the enter key. This right here is my mean, or the common average, $1,136.13. I could do the median, but I might end up including this value. So I'm just going to put the median here. If you're smart on Excel, you can figure out how to ignore that one. But for right now, I'll just put it here. Now I want the median. I go back up to where I have my functions. Select statistical is most recently used. I'm going to limit it down to statistical. Look at all these different statistical functions. One of those in there, there is median. I'll select median. Say okay. Okay. There's my median value, $1,151.03. Pretty cool. Why bother using a C++ program to calculate the mean and the median of a data file when you can just use Excel? Well, maybe you need that as part of a bigger program. Or, in these examples, the main thing is learning how to use C++ to read a data file. Enjoy and have fun with this one.